I've been paralyzed waiting for this parallax. What's going on, PowerDirector peeps? Today is Tablet Tuesday. That means I get to show you how to do the Parallax Effect using the PowerDirector Mobile Video Editor app.
Here we are in the PowerDirector app. If you're new to my channel and you want to learn how to use PowerDirector, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. The parallax effect creates a video from a photo by adding simultaneous pan and zoom, which creates a motion effect for your viewers. So, in this video, I'm going to show you how to create this unique effect for your videos. Let's put some motion in the mountains. As you can see, I have a picture of some mountains in the timeline. If I play this, you'll see it's just a static picture, but I want to create some motion to jazz it up a bit. And I want to make those clouds move sideways and have the mountains move forward. I need to create a picture of the clouds and a separate picture of the mountains so I can make those two movements independently. Now, I'm going to use PhotoDirector for this, but you can use any photo editor on your device that can remove parts of an image and replace them with a green screen or a transparent background. So let's go ahead and go over to PhotoDirector. So you want to tap on edit, you want to tap on pictures, you want to go to the picture that you want to use on your device and tap that picture, and it'll go ahead and open it up. So at this point, you want to go to tools, and we want to tap on removal. You want to tap on this plus sign, and then you want to go ahead and tap on the mountains. All right, so we want to go ahead and remove these, and we're going to just kind of go over the top of these. Not too much of a concern for if it's perfect or not. Just want to make sure we get them. If you make a mistake on anything, you can always hit the minus sign, hold your finger on it, and if you want to be precise, you can do that. You can tap on the plus sign and add anything back. Same thing, hold your finger over it. And once you're done, you can go ahead and tap on remove. And as you can see, that removed the mountains and the ground and replaced them with clouds. So if you like how it looks, you can go ahead and tap on the check sign. And then you can go ahead and tap on the export. And it'll save your photo. Next, we need to create an image of just the mountains with no other background in there. So you want to tap on home. You want to tap on edit, pictures. You want to tap on the mountain picture again. And this time you want to tap on cutout. Now you want to go ahead and tap the plus sign. And you want to go ahead and tap on the image. Once again, you can hold your finger down, make any adjustments if you want to make sure that you get all of the mountain in there. Next, you can go ahead and tap on cut. And as you can see, it kept the selection that we made and got rid of everything else at the top. So it's transparent, which is what that checkerboard means, but we don't want it to be transparent. We want it to have a green background so we can use the chroma key here in PowerDirector. So we're going to tap on green. You'll change that background to green. You want to tap on the check mark. And you want to tap on export to save it as well. And now you got your two photos saved. You got a photo of just clouds, and then you got a photo of the mountains with no background. So now we're going to go back to PowerDirector. And we don't need this picture, so we're going to tap on it. We're going to tap the trash bin to get rid of it. And we're going to go ahead and tap on the overlay icon. We're going to go to photo. We're going to go to photo director. And we're going to choose the clouds. And we'll tap on the plus sign. And now we'll tap back. And we'll tap back again. Now we want to go ahead and move these clouds sideways. So the first thing that we need to do is tap on the clouds. And we need to go ahead and size them up to fill in the screen. Then we want to tap on transform keyframe. And we're going to actually pinch out more to whatever size we want. And then we want to go ahead and move the clouds over to the left until we can see the border around it. And it should lock it into place there. So now we want to go ahead and tap on create keyframe. And we have a keyframe right here at this position. So now the photo is locked in here. So the next thing that you want to do is move your playhead to the end of the clip. And you want to make sure that the Y position stays the same. So the Y position is 0.574. We want to make sure that that stays the same because as we move this sideways, we want to make sure that it stays level. So now we're going to go ahead and move the clip over. And now we should be level here because the Y position is the same. And it automatically creates a keyframe here. So if we tap on back, what happens now is when we play this, it moves sideways. Now we need to go ahead and place the mountains back into the picture. And we want to make the mountains zoom in at us while the clouds are moving sideways, creating that type of three-dimensional movement. So we're going to go ahead and tap on the overlay icon. We're going to go to photo. We're going to go to photo director. And this time we're going to choose the mountains. We're going to tap on the mountains and we're going to tap the plus sign. And it should add it right underneath the other image where our playhead is. We'll go ahead and tap on back and we'll tap back. We'll go ahead and tap on the mountains and we'll frame them and pinch out so that it fills the screen. Then we're going to go ahead and tap on chroma key. And we're going to tap our eyedropper and we'll tap the green. It'll remove that green from there. Now we can tap back. And now you can actually see the clouds and the mountains together because we use that chroma key to get rid of the green. But what we also want to do is create some motion for the mountains to move forward. So we'll go ahead and tap on transform keyframe. And we're going to go ahead and tap on the keyframe button to add a keyframe at the beginning. We'll move our playhead to the end. And we'll go ahead and scale this out to around a 2. And it should create a keyframe right there at the end. Now, if we move our playhead back to the beginning and we play this back.
Parallax.
If you like what you see, I'll leave a link to try out the PowerDirector app in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.